Good day to everyone! This is the sixth lesson in the course Calculation in LIRA-SAPR, and in this lesson we will perform coordination for local axes of finite elements. Why do we need to do it? First of all, open Help. In window Help, open Search tab, and in line type sign convention. From the list select first line. In the right part of the window, you can see the picture of a bar with directions of local axes and internal efforts that can arise in the bar. In this table, you can see all types of efforts that can arise in the bar, their description and direction if positive sign is set. Also, in this window, there is the same information about the plates and solids. The essence of this lesson is that the local axes of the finite elements must have the same direction with the global axis. To provide that, we have to coordinate local axes of finite elements. Close the Help window. Click on the button Flex of Drawing. On first tab, check local axes of bars and click on the button Redraw. We see arrows appeared on the bars. We don't need to coordinate the local axis of the bars, because in the bars it is necessary that that axis is directed upwards. In the window Flex of Drawing, uncheck local axis of bars and check local axis of plates and solid FE. And click on the button Redraw. As we can see, in our plates, direction of Z axis is chaotic. We need to direct axis Z upwards. Select plates with command Select Elements. Click on the Plates tab and select command Local Axis of Plates. In this window, click Codirect. Now Z axis of plates directed downwards. Select plates again and click on the button Opposite. Now in the window Flex of Drawing, uncheck local axis of plates and solid FE and check local axis of plates and solid FE for results. Click Redraw. Local axis for results must be coordinated with global axis. Select all plates. In window Local axis of plates, select second tab. Check XOZ minus and click Apply. Local axes of plates are coordinated. As we can see, after these operations with plates, something happened with load, so I will reset it. Now select Solids and click on the tab Solids. Find command Local axis of solids. In this window, check XOY and click Apply. Now local axis of all elements of our problem are coordinated. We don't need to coordinate local axis of one node element, because the result of analysis of one node element is only displacements and no efforts will arise. Don't forget to save your problem and see you on the next lessons.